On this show, we have a special guest host that's going to give us a very different perspective on some of the points we've been looking at here. So, you want mediocrity? Well, this is the place to get it. Let me tell you something. Five easy steps, and I'll have you there. Step number one. Let's get right into it now. Okay, the first thing you want to do is you want to read your presentation. Now, I know audiences say that they hate presentations when they're read to them. They really, yeah, they say things like, well, why did I come here to listen to you? You know, why don't you just mail me the speech or the presentation? I can sit at home in my pajamas and have a cup of tea or coffee. I don't need to come here and listen to you. That is true. But keep in mind, this is your presentation. It's not their presentation. Think about the advantages of reading your presentation. You don't have to put up with the sleepers. The people that are falling asleep in row 3, back in row 9, you don't have to be disturbed by them. You know what I'm saying to you? You don't have to watch the person over here in row 5 near the wall that's got their head down and their cell phone texting. You don't get disturbed by this stuff. I'm telling you, stay buried in your script and eliminate the distraction. Point number 2. Now, read my lips. Do not rehearse your presentation. No preparation is needed. You don't want to look too confident, too comfortable up there. You don't want to give the impression that you're an expert or that you've done this before. You're just there to deliver some information, nothing more. You don't want to look too professional. That's not the point here, is it? The point is mediocrity, folks. That's what we're going for. Okay, now, point number 3. Stay with me now on this thing. Do not commit the gross mistake of looking at the audience. You are not there to make a connection with that audience. Your purpose is not to appear interested in them, not to appear interested in their problems or their reactions to you. You stay focused on the information in front of you, and you eliminate the possibility of being branded a likable person. An empathetic person, a person interested in their problems. Hey, this is not a popularity contest here, folks. It is only a presentation. Moving along, point number 4. Do not, under any circumstances, confuse the audience by telling them a personal story or two, you know, to demonstrate a point. Just stick to the facts and figures that you got there in front of you. Let the audience put those things into perspective, you know? It's not up to you to do the creative work for them, right? I mean, you talk about your audience participation. Well, there you are. Okay, and look, we're already at number 5, and number 5's a biggie, folks. Do yourselves a favor. Do not ever have a Q&A, question and answer, at the end of your presentation. Are you crazy? You don't ever want to have to be put in a position of having to say, I don't know. Oh, sure, a professional speaker might say, good question. Thanks for asking it. You know, I don't know that, but I will research it. And if you come up at the end of the presentation and give me some contact information, I'll find out and I'll let you know what I discover. I'm happy to do that. Are there any other questions? You don't want to be put in that position. You do not want to be branded professional. We're going for mediocrity, folks, here. Don't forget the purpose. So let's recap. This is what you're going to do. 5 steps. You're going to read your presentation. You're not going to prepare. You're not going to make eye contact. You're not, under any circumstances, going to confuse your audience by telling them personal stories. And you will not make the hugest blunder of all, which is having a Q&A at the end. You follow these 5 steps, my friends, and you will elevate mediocrity to a fine art and your personal reputation with it. I guarantee it. Well, there you have it. That's not exactly my take on things, but thanks anyway to our special guest at this week's show. By the way, I just want to remind you that I am posting training videos on the website, and I posted one this past week on using note cards. So you might want to come by the website, the blog, and take a visit. It may interest you. I think it's a good learning point. Thanks for visiting. Happy speaking. And I'll see you next time.